welcome or welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time seeing my face, hi, my name is Monica and I post videos on money, travel, and lifestyle. And if you are interested in topics like those, you already know what to do. Be sure to subscribe down below to the channel and join this community of people who are learning about these stimulus checks specifically. Of course, like this video, Hulk smash the like button, WWE the like button. Thank you for doing that. And of course, turn on your post notifications so you never miss any of my stimulus check updates or any of my uploads. So let's get right into it. So there is growing support for a second stimulus payment to help Americans. Let me say that again. There is growing support for a second stimulus payment to help Americans. Now, there have been lots of proposals so far, as I'm sure you know. There was the Patriot Pay, the Heroes Fund, the Emergency Money for the People Act, ABC Act, cancellation of rent and mortgage payments. There have been so many proposals so far, but as of today, May 8th, Senator Kamala Harris, along with Senator Bernie Sanders and Ed Markey, have introduced the Monthly Economic Crisis Support Act, which is a rebate program that would provide monthly stimulus payments to eligible recipients until the pandemic ends. So essentially, that would be monthly rebates. So first, let's talk about what you would receive if you are eligible. And second, let's talk about who is eligible. So starting with what you would receive. You would receive $2,000 per month or $4,000 per month for married filing jointly, plus an additional $2,000 per month for each qualified dependent, up to a maximum of 3 dependents. So that means a wife and a husband would receive $4,000 together, and they would receive $2,000 per eligible dependent. So if they have 3 children, that's $10,000 they are receiving every month. Now that sounds like universal basic income to me. I do not see any senators going for it, but it is another proposal in the ring. It looks like they are leaving out dependents again, but it says any non-resident alien individual would be ineligible. Any individual who can be claimed as a dependent under Section 151 would be ineligible, and an estate or trust would also not be eligible. Eligibility is based on income. So the bill states there are limitations on the adjusted gross income, and payments shall be reduced if they make more than these limits, meaning that you'll still get something, but not the full $2,000 if your adjusted gross income is above these limits. So you would be eligible if you make $200,000 or less in the case of a joint return. So if you and your husband, or you and your wife, or just a couple, whoever is filing jointly, you would be eligible if you make $200,000 or less in the case of a joint return. If you make $150,000 or less in the case of a head of household return, and if you are neither a joint return filer or a head of households filer, you would need to make under $100,000 to be eligible for this $2,000 monthly payment. Now, I did look through the act. It says immediately upon the enactment of this act, out of any money in the treasury not otherwise appropriated, there shall be appropriated $250 million to the Department of the Treasury to carry out this purpose. So they are saying $250 million to carry out this act. Now let's talk about how you would be paid. They are saying payments would be made via direct deposit when possible, like these stimulus payments that didn't even reach everybody's bank account. They're saying these stimulus payments would be made via direct deposit if the IRS has the taxpayer's information on file. Now I do believe those of you who may have been non-filers or just filed this year, they're gonna have your most up-to-date information to kind of get these checks going out. And I do think a second round of direct deposits will be more successful this time because they have more people's information on file. Millions of people have been flocking to that Get My Payment portal. So the IRS should have more up-to-date information in regards to people's bank account information. The proposal also calls for the payments to be made through other means as determined by the Secretary of the Treasury, including through the use of stored value cards and online payment systems. So the big question is when and how long would it be going for? Now, even though it's being proposed in May, it would be retroactive to March 1st, 2020. So from March 1st, it says it would end 3 months after the end of the emergency, as declared by the Secretary of Health and Human Services. So we are going from March 1st to 3 months after this pandemic is over that you will be receiving these benefits. The bill would also prevent financial institutions from freezing or garnishing any portion of your payment. So all of you people who received your payment in your bank account, but the bank may have taken a portion because you were overdrawn or because you had fees or whatever the case is, they are putting language in this act that says, no banks, you cannot freeze or garnish any portion of these payments. Now, this proposal is one of the most expensive put forward so far, and Congress really seems to be taking their time moving forward with the next stimulus package. It seems there have been so many proposals for direct payments. I definitely think that we can expect to see some in the near future. It's kind of like darts, you know, you keep throwing darts at a wall and you throw and you keep making more proposals, direct payments, and one of them has to stick. So Democrats are really gunning for these direct payments. They want more help to be directly sent to Americans who are in need. They're also saying they want state and local government help. A lot of people have been talking about how they also want support for police officers and teachers. So this is what the Democrats are really running on. They are saying direct payments, state and local government help. There have been some people on the Republican side who are saying, we are not bailing out blue states. We are not giving them money for whatever poor decisions they made on a statewide level. But if you look at the numbers, New York and LA give the most to the federal pot. I mean, if you look at taxes on a basic, like, numbers thing, not even like red or blue, whatever, New York and LA give the most to the federal pot. So if you want to spread that federal pot money around the country, it should definitely go to blue states. I mean, New York and LA are blue states, but I digress. The Senate wants support for small businesses and they want tax cuts. They mainly are focused on small businesses. They are saying, we do not need to see any liability for small businesses. They're also saying we want to make sure they feel supported and are helped throughout this crisis. But the main issue is that we can't keep giving small businesses all this money and they still don't have customers. The only way to have customers is if the customers have money. The customers don't have money because they're unemployed and because they haven't gotten their dang stimulus check yet. So they really need to get these stimulus checks moving so that we can actually help the small businesses. Now, a few Senate Republicans have shown support for the expanded monthly payments after the CARES Act, which included, you know, the one-time $1,200 payment, but we shall see what they are agreeing on very soon. Now, Harris has said that Congress's relief efforts so far are not nearly enough to meet the needs of this historic crisis. I mean, if you look at it, nothing like this has ever happened in history. We've had some things that are close, but nothing like this has ever happened in history. So there needs to be a new way of supporting. Saunders is saying the one-time $1,200 check that many Americans recently received or did not receive is not nearly enough to pay the rent, put food on the table, and make ends meet. He also said Congress has a responsibility to make sure that every working class household in America receives a $2,000 emergency payment a month for each family member. You heard it right. Saunders says, Congress, you have a responsibility. It's like, you know, when your mom like points at you and she's like, you have a responsibility to protect your little sister or something like that. But he's saying, you need to take care of these Americans the same way that they have been taking care of you with all these taxes all these years. So that's the end of my video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Also put down in the comments below what you think about all of this. It is madness in Congress, and there's going to be madness in the coming weeks about this, but we shall see what they all agree on and what the next stimulus will look like. Definitely like this video. Please take a moment and like this video if you like content like this. It really, really helps my channel out so much. Of course, turn on your post notifications, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll catch you all in my next stimulus check update. Be safe, guys. Bye. Also, please consider signing the Emergency Money for the People Act. It actually exceeded its goal of 100,000 signatures by May 15th, so no more signatures are needed, but the more, the better. Definitely go check that out. The link is in my description. Now, the Emergency Money for the People Act is that $2,000 monthly payment to every qualifying American over the age of 16 until employment returns to the pre-levels, you know, before the pandemic. So check out the link in the description.